The current drought situation in Hawaii has been going on for several months. I remind you all the time, right? There's no end in sight. We are in the middle of the largest ocean in the world. How can we have water shortages or potential water shortages? Is there a way to use that water? Joining us this morning to answer that question is Kathleen Pahinui from the Board of Water Supply. Good morning, Kathleen. Thanks
morning,
for being
Shelley.
With us.
Thank you for having me today.
First of all, can you give us like a brief overview of how we actually get our water now?
Sure. Our water on Oahu comes from the ground. It's groundwater. We pump it out with deep water wells or shafts like Halava Shaft, things like that. Yeah.
This is just rainfall that settles down underground and
correct.
We can get
it out.
Correct.
It takes about 25 years from the top of the watershed all the way to get into the aquifer below.
Okay, so speaking of water, there's a way to desalinate ocean water. I guess in the past it's been very expensive. It takes a lot of energy to do it. There's some cons to it because there's waste product to it. Why don't we do that here in Hawaii?
Well, actually, we have a project that's already been started. We're in contract for it. Yes, you're right. Desal is still not inexpensive. It's still more expensive than just pumping the water out of the ground. But the technology has definitely improved over the last dozen or so years. So we're going to start a small project out at Campbell by Campbell Industrial Park at Kalailoa. And we're going to use that water to replace the potable water that the industries use over at Campbell, which will release about, hopefully, up to 3 million gallons per day of potable water that can go back into the drinking water system versus being used for non-potable sources. We're going to start with about 1.7 million gallons per day, and then it is scalable up to 5 million gallons per day.
How many gallons do we need on Oahu per day?
We pump on average 145 million gallons per day.
So we would need a few of these plants to be completely
correct.
Self-sufficient.
Correct.
Or not getting it out of underground.
Correct. And it's going to take a variety of things that we do. We're not going to be able to always use just desal. Because the cost is expensive, and you have to locate them in the right areas. One of the byproducts, as you know, you just mentioned, of desal is the brine, and you have to be very careful on how you dispose of that because it can affect the near shoreline environment. But because the caprock, the clay marine sediment that overlies that area, we believe we'll be able to inject it back in and it'll slowly dilute. So these are all things that we have to adjust for and watch why we're doing this project.
Yeah, because too much salt, you put it back. A lot of people say just put it back in the ocean, but I guess there's organisms that can't take that much salt.
There's always consequences to your actions, so we have to be very careful and thoughtful.
Would you say this is like a test bed project, or is this the way that we're going to go with getting our water?
Well, this is kind of a test project for us. You know, it's something we've been wanting to do for a very long time, and now we're finally able to start executing it. If it's successful, yes, we are going to look at other locations around the island, but this is the first one, and that's, you know, let's get people off of potable water that don't need to be on potable water.
I mean, eventually, if this works out, we won't have to worry about the drought. I mean, there'll be concerns, of course, but I guess Florida has been really, they use it the most, maybe?
California uses a lot. San Diego, I believe, has quite a large desal plant.
How's it been going for them?
They've been using it there. California in general, because of the drought that they've been experiencing for multiple years, they've gotten very creative. They use a lot of recycled water. They're using some desal as well as still pumping from the ground.
Wow. I think that's all good news. I mean, I've been reading about this for the last couple of months. I'm like, why don't we do this? I've talked to some people, but that's terrific that we're going in that direction. I think Hawaii should lead the way in solar energy or geothermal or wind, whatever, but we should lead the way because of the amount of sunshine we get. We should also, we're in the ocean, right?
Yeah.
Thank you so much
for
joining us.
Appreciate your time today.
Yes, it's
aloha.
Been excellent. Thank you very much.